Why do we only use the first 7 letters of the alphabet to name the 12 notes we use in Western music? Wouldn't it make much more sense to use 12 letters and get rid of all the complicated accidentals? This would also mean that the black keys on the piano would finally get their own unique names instead of just being variations of their VIP neighbors. After all, the tones they produce aren't any less important. Unless you have perfect pitch, you have no way of telling whether this tone came from a black or white key. So why is it that only the white keys have their own letters, and why does each black key have 2 different names? First of all, it's important to understand that both the layout of the keys on the piano and their names are connected to one of the most important concepts in the history of Western music: diatonic scales. I already explained the logic behind these scales in a different video, so I'll just do a short summary here. A diatonic scale is a 7-note scale built out of 5 whole tones and 2 semitones. Since we can begin the scale on each of our 7 notes, there are 7 different diatonic scales. 2 of them, the major and minor scales, have been the most important scales in Western music for hundreds of years. The white keys on the piano are tuned according to the diatonic scale, so although they are identical in size, there are actually 2 different intervals between them. That's why we need only 5 black keys to fill the larger gaps in the scale, thus creating our complete 12-tone harmonic system. Now, that explains the layout of the keys on the piano, but what about their names? Wouldn't it still make sense to use 12 different letters for our 12 keys? Well, let's give it a try. If we use 12 letters, the C major scale would look like this. Now, of course, we're not familiar with some of these letters in a musical context, but there's another reason why this doesn't feel right. These letters don't appear like this in the alphabet. The C major scale we know simply uses the first 7 letters of the alphabet, starting from C, without any gaps between them. In a 12-letter system, there are letters missing in our scale, so you would have to memorize for each scale which letters appear in it and which ones don't. The thing is, although our full harmonic system consists of 12 notes, the vast majority of Western music, from classical to pop, is based on diatonic 7-note scales. Why? Well, you could compare this to the variety of spices you find in your kitchen. If you used all of them in a single dish, the result might be interesting, but it would most likely lack balance or harmony. So, while all 12 notes have their time to shine, a 7-note scale provides orientation, a harmonic foundation, a hierarchy between notes, and most importantly, a tonal center, in a way that a 12-tone chromatic scale never could. Each time someone asks about the key of a specific song, they're asking which major or minor scale provides its harmonic structure. So, since diatonic 7-note scales play such a huge role in our music, using 7 letters has one major advantage. Each of the scales we use, every single major and minor scale, can be written down using the same 7 letters, in the same order, just from different starting points, and with a few accidentals in the right places. In fact, this is a fundamental principle of our diatonic system. Every letter is allowed to appear only once in each scale. By following this rule, we can also begin to understand why we need sharps in certain keys and flats in others. For example, the black key that appears in the F major scale could be an A sharp or a B flat. Thanks to our 7-letter rule, we can tell at once that it must be a B flat, because there can only be one A in our scale. Just to give another example, let's play a major scale starting on this black key. Obviously, an A sharp major scale would contradict our rule in several places. So we need to call this a B-flat major scale. And the key of B-flat major therefore has two flats in its key signature. Finally, this also explains why sometimes even white keys need to switch their names. In an F-sharp major scale, it turns out that this white key can't remain an F. Instead, we need to give it a new name, E-sharp. So, even though our system of 12 notes, 7 letters, and accidentals might seem a little confusing at first, it's actually quite useful in our diatonic musical universe. And it follows simple rules that make it pretty easy to figure out any scale yourself with just a little practice. I hope you found this helpful. If you have any other questions you would like me to answer, let me know in the comments. If you want to support what I'm doing, you can like and subscribe. And you can also check out my previous videos about the 12-note system and the logic behind musical scales. Thanks for watching, and I hope you'll find the time to listen to some good music today.